Hi, and welcome to Let's Design. Congratulations, you must be getting married. I'm Holly, and this is Rock, our designer.
Hi, everyone.
We're going to be doing a couple of bridal bouquets for you, two attendant bouquets, a corsage, and a boutonniere piece. So first off, let Rock explain what we need for our supplies.
Well, we're going to need wire cutters, as always. Got to have a good pair of wire cutters. Okay. And sharp scissors, because we're going to use a little ribbon here.
You want to
got to have a good sharp cut. A bouquet holder, which actually these are already made, styrofoam in the handle. It's done for you.
Available at all craft stores?
Right. The backing, which is also available at the craft store.
Oh, okay. And are these available in different colors?
Yeah, you can get them in an antique white or an ivory.
Oh, okay.
Or
so
a white.
Match your gown.
Yeah, some can wear white, some can wear ivory. Then, greenery. I've got some, you know, flat fern.
Okay.
Some
ivy.
Bright green ivy, because it'll show up. Because we're going to do this in like a white.
Okay.
There's many different shades of white. This is, everything I've chosen here is a white.
White, okay.
A gardenias.
Those are pretty.
Some white lilac.
Okay.
Which I'm going to break that down and use it in clusters.
Okay.
Some white freesia. I've got some white hydrangea here also, some smaller pieces. And some white cabbage rose, or
what is that?
Ranunculus.
Ranunculus.
Right.
Okay.
You have a hard time with that.
I know.
And then I just found a little bit of grosgrain ribbon. It's like a tone-on-tone white stripe. I'm just going to add a little bit of ribbon in at the end, just since we're going to do a nosegay-style bouquet here, because our dress, actually, that I'm going to work with this, has a lot of beadwork.
Right. And you don't want to cover that up.
Right. Because you've already put a lot into the dress, a lot into the beadwork, and if you notice, it carries all the way down.
Okay.
So we just want a nice, big, sprawling nosegay to accent the dress, because remember, your dress is the most important. Your nosegay is an accessory.
So all of your flowers are an accessory.
Right, and with this dress that we have here, we don't want this big, huge
to overpower the dress.
To overpower the dress.
Okay, well, let's get started. Can't wait.
This is actually a lot easier than you think it is once you get the principles going. Because this is a really intense time. You've got a lot going on. You've got a lot of plans. You've got a lot of people.
What's so nice about silks, though, you can do it, you know, months in advance.
You can have this done months in advance. You could do it, you know,
right after you get engaged.
Exactly, and have it all ready. Make your decisions and move forward. And then it's one
instead of having
off
to worry about going
list.
To the florist and, you know, getting your bouquet.
Correct. You're right. So we're going to start. What I did was I just bought a block of 2-inch styrofoam.
Okay.
It was less than a couple dollars. And I'm going to use that to station my bouquet in while I make it.
Oh, okay.
What I'm going to do is just insert my holder into it.
And facing towards you. Okay.
Yeah. That way it's done. It's ready. It's stable. And we can get started. I'm going to start with the fern first. Cut this
and
down.
Would you always start with the greenery?
Yeah, you want to kind of build your body of greenery and then go back and include your flowers.
Okay.
And I'm just cutting this down into sections here. I have my one larger section.
Okay.
I'm going to dip it into my glue pot here. Right straight onto the lip. Bouquet.
Okay.
How easy was that?
Very easy. I could do that.
Second piece.
So I didn't have to worry about these pressures when I got married because you were there.
Right. I had all the pressure when she got married.
Exactly. Yes. But you did a fabulous job.
Yeah. Actually, everything worked out really well.
It's very pretty.
Except for what we thought was an earthquake, but that was actually the church kind of trembling when you walked in in a near to white dress. This one, we're going to insert right into the bottom of the holder.
So at 12 o'clock and at 6 o'clock.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Use this as a clock face again.
The same as a wreath, maybe?
Correct.
Okay, good.
Now I'm going to take my shorter pieces that I have here. Stand to the side.
This would be such a great thing that, I mean, the bride and her bridesmaids could do. That would be fun.
Yeah, it would be fun. As long as you watch the tape in its entirety and pay attention to what you're doing. And we're going to insert to the next side here. And you almost have like a diamond shape, and you're like, I thought we were going to be round. It will be round.
Okay.
Next, I'm going to start with my next piece of fern. I'm going to insert that down into the top of the bouquet.
Okay.
It starts to establish our depth, our lines, and our roundness.
Okay.
Same with this one. Facing in towards itself, each other. Now we'll begin with the ivy. And I'm going to start from the outside. I'm going to cut my longer pieces of ivy right off of my bunch.
I can help you.
I'm going to bend them back a little bit.
Okay, and bend them down so they're growing down? Is mm-hmm. that right. the look we want to go
and
for?
And I'm going to insert this into the side here. Where we didn't have, see how it's beginning
right,
to.
Right, okay. I one. See. There is a method to your madness.
There is a method to my madness. And to the opposite side here. I want it to be a nice flowing nosegay. I don't want it to be really, really tight and compact.
Because some nosegays, I mean, but actually, I mean, that's popular as well right now.
You can do it really tight, compact, and we'll, actually, we're going to move to that later when we do one of the attendance bouquets. But this, I kind of want it to be a little more flowing, a little more dramatic.
I think this is a great idea, though, to have you and your attendants make your bouquets. I think that would be a fun girls' night out.
You can make it part of the whole...
Right, the wedding.
Planning. I'm going to insert this one here at the bottom. Okay. And one more. You can stop now. You're getting a little carried away there.
Sorry. Hello.
It's not an ivy bouquet. It's going to be flowers. We're just using the ivy.
That's just to cover up the mechanics, correct?
Right. Now a couple of the shorter pieces. I'm going to go ahead and work into directly down into the top of the bouquet holder.
So. Okay.
And the same to this side here. See, now we have a nice flowing effect to get started. Now, at this point, we're ready to start to add flowers.
Okay.
So I want to start with the gardenias.
And that's because
they're the largest.
Okay.
And usually, even in fresh flowers, they're the most expensive. So that's your predominant flower.
Okay.
This gardenia has a bud, a smaller bloom, and a larger bloom. I'm going to cut the largest bloom off here. So it's about probably 4.5 inches long. It's pretty just as it is.
It is pretty.
And I'm going to insert this directly at 12 o'clock to the top. Then I'm going to move to my next largest bloom on my three stems of gardenias. Again, I've cut it about the same. About 4 inches long. I'm gonna do.
So you could use, instead of gardenias, you could use, I mean, roses in full bloom as well for this,
oh, definitely,
right?
To get the nice open. Mm-hmm. This just looked good to me and I like them. Gardenias and roses are, you know, totally traditional wedding flowers.
Flowers, right.
And my third larger gardenia.
Plus, what's so nice about doing silks at a